by factors which is very minimal value, that is called law of limiting factor. It means the concentration is very less. The factor which have the very less concentration that show impact onto the complete process. So that is called limiting factor. So the according to law of limiting factor, if carbon dioxide taken as a limiting factor, the limitation must be 0.03 to 0.04 concentration. So that given by scientist Blackman. And come to the temperature. So here C3 plants and C4 plants are there. In C3 plants, the optimum temperature for their photosynthesis 15 degrees to 25 degrees. Whereas in C4 plants, the optimum temperature required for them 35 degrees to 45 degrees of temperature. And here, the conifers also able to synthesize at a low temperature. So that is 6 degrees of temperature. So few bacteria, blue-green algae bacteria, some blue-green bacteria, BGA. So they also conducted their photosynthesis very high temperature, approximately 70 degrees of temperature. But every 10 degrees of temperature, here the photosynthetic yield become twice. Up to where? So the temperature went high and high, the chlorophyll is going to denature, that is called photooxidation or photobleaching. In general condition, the photobleaching or photooxidation is escaped by the carotenoids. It means the chlorophylls are protected from photooxidation by carotenoids as well as phycobilins. That's why carotenoids and phycobilins are considered as accessory pigments. At high temperature, there is a denature of chlorophylls that show impact onto the negative impact onto the photosynthetic yield. Next, water. Water is the most important element. 60% of the cell value is occupied by water. So, in the presence of water, the enzymes are activated. The enzymes are activated and the reactions are mediated in the presence of the water also, because hydrolysis reactions. Without water, no photosynthesis. So, water also one of the key elements for photosynthesis. And oxygen. Generally, oxygen is not the factor involved in the photosynthesis, but it is a yield. It is a product of photosynthesis. It is one of the end products. The concentration of oxygen when more in the photosynthetic atmosphere, the plant can go for the photorespiration. So photorespiration means there is no oxygen production, there is no ATP production, there is no starch production. But carbon dioxide concentration is gradually increasing by doing a photorespiration. Okay, so by doing a photorespiration. When oxygen concentration is more, that inhibits the photosynthetic rate, the effect is called von Bohr effect. So this is postulated by scientist von Bohr. So the von Bohr effect means nothing but of in high concentration of oxygen, the plants are leads to photorespiration. So in the photorespiration, the CO2 is released. So gradually it promotes the increment of the carbon dioxide and promotes the photosynthesis. Okay, but at high concentration of the oxygen, the photosynthesis process is inhibited. That effect is called von Bohr effect. So these are the factors affecting the